So we do planning here. Out of this product backlog, the big one, the small teams backlogs, individual teams backlogs, they merge from here. So they, so that's like team one, team two, team three, team four. So that's, they are.
These will be individual teams product backlogs or sprint backlogs?
No, these will be sprint backlogs. I'm sorry.
No, product backlogs. These are four product backlogs for individual teams.
So how will you manage priorities across these four product backlogs?
So can we present and then we take the questions, or do you want to take the questions?
So we have these four product backlogs, the individual teams product backlogs, and then we have individual teams product owners as well. So what happens? The product owners, they meet on a frequent basis, deciding rather discussing the shift in priorities if there are any, or if there are any change in business. So like scrum happens for that, like that. For product owners, there's a frequent meeting. That's maybe once in a week or once in 2 weeks. So they discuss the shift in priorities, the business needs, and then according to that, and they communicate these things to their respective teams so that their product backlog can be arranged, and this final one can be adjusted accordingly as well. So there is a like senior product owner, under the supervision of senior product owner, this thing is managed, and then we have individual product owners for each team for their, and then we have individual product backlogs. Is that it, sir?
Yes.
Okay. Please.
So just one thing I would add to this. So once you have dependencies and priorities on the main product backlog, so, and you have tagged that which team is going to take that, then automatically it's a filter of your main product backlog which goes into your multiple teams. And that's when you later on take, as and when you decide, and at this level itself you did the release planning for the whole project per se. So cadence of the sprint is going to be the same. So now you, since that is a filter of that, with the given priority already, so now you keep on taking it and churning it out in terms of your sprints, and that's how you bring out your sprint backlog.
And then there also needs to be a concept of sprint zero that needs to be done, right? So sprint zero would be everything that needs to be planned for the release, and the upcoming sprints need to be discussed in sprint zero. And again, the product owner thing that Ankit just explained, also the product owner's meeting that he explained, has to be in advance of the sprint. It should not be, if we have to do it in sprint A, they're meeting in sprint A. They should be meeting in a prior sprint or a couple of prior sprints.
And this is a sprint zero is a concept for each release, or is it for one entire project?
For a single time.
So is it for a single time?
Yeah,
or
it should be for
for a release.
For a release.
For each release,
for
the release.
Not for each sprint.
For each release. I'm asking.
Yeah. Yeah.
Let's say in 1 year they have three releases. So
for each release, you will do a sprint zero, because you can't have a vision of three releases from now.
Right.
On a high level, you can have, and probably you would not like to spend your energy over there. Then otherwise, you will not be able to respond to the change. So this is going to change for sure.
Okay.
So one more thing, I think we said that the right tool is also important while taking this into place, because I understand that. While scaling, even though the normal agile principle says that we should give more weightage to individual interactions over process and tools, however, I believe that as the moment you scale, collaboration tools play an important role actually to bring these things in visual
to everyone.
Are you guys done or there's more to it?
No, so this part of it is done.
This
then
part
we have second part of it. So we
get the produce part.
Okay. So now we'll get into the produce part.
Produce part, yeah. So who's going to come for produce part?
I have a question from this. How do we get this product backlog into sprint backlog, team backlog? He will? Okay. I thought he has answered.
The next part we have is the produce part. And in produce part, here what we're talking about is when the sprint starts. So when during the sprint, what we do? So we would do, we'll start with the sprint planning. The sprint planning has to be proper. We need to have proper interactions with the product owner. And only then the team also needs to break up the user stories. Again, they might have n number of questions. So again, a lot of discussion with product owner needs to happen while we're planning it. And then we start with the daily stand-up meeting. When we have the plan ready, we do the daily stand-ups. When we do the daily stand-ups, we also need to ensure that we are logging in our efforts correctly in the rightly in the right quantity in the tools that we are using. The tools, like Gaurav said, are very, very important, and that's what will help us to have the burn-down charts ready.
I'm assuming you're also having the task board and estimates are going over there.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes.
Right.
So that we'll be doing in the planning session. And the estimation needs to be done. Estimation would be a part of the planning session. And once we're done with the planning session again, then we need to do the inspect and adapt, and I think that Gaurav will take over.
Right. So regarding the burn down chart, one thing I would like to add here. See, regarding the burn down chart, so what? So there's a tool like you mentioned. Like Jira, for example, Grasshopper. So there you can see the individual board of each team, and then you can see for burn down chart. Sorry, the individual burn down chart for each team, and then the big burn down chart for the release. You know that has the data, the combined data of all the teams in it. So you can actually track that.
So does Jira support scaling of scrums?
Okay. So I don't know if you want to go into that question of related to a tool, but
yeah. It's about burn down charts.
Yes. So Greenhopper in Jira, you can create boards with your own queries. Now it could be a conglomeration of 5 projects, and then you can have separate boards of each project, because there it has a concept of queries. So even when you write the query, you can have even multiple projects as well. So I mean, in my current organization, I already do that.
So in Jira, it's possible to create, say, 5 teams for the same project. So you have 5 burn-down charts for individual team, and there's one at the project level.
Absolutely, right. There is. Right. For that sprint only.
Yes.
For that sprint only, yeah, yes. So a couple of things I would like to add here. One more important aspect is grooming. So grooming of the stories for the next sprint, basically. So now every team has their product backlogs and something which they are currently working on, but the product owner is working on the future stories. So that product grooming is quite important, actually. Quite important in terms of, so that you can eliminate the basic questions which are going to stop you doing in order to, you know, firm up the priority or the dependency. And that will also verify, because at this level, at a high level, when you set the dependency, probably it didn't have the view of the development. But when you do that grooming, that gives you the perspective that, hey, I'm dependent on that feature and or that story until that happens. So product backlog grooming is quite important. As far as scaling goes, first of all, you have to continue to do it at your team level. But anything as an output which comes back, the product owner is supposed to go back to that meeting where all the product owners meet and then redefine the priority of that. So that's a feed back to that thing, actually.
Where are you estimating stories? At the product backlog level or individual?
Yeah, so once these product backlogs are created, after that...
The main one or the individual one?
The individual. So after that is when we get into the produce part. So just before the produce part, I'm going to create a sprint backlog for that team. That's where I will do the estimation.
Okay. So each team could have a different...
So that life cycle is same as Scrum suggests. Exactly. So once you have product backlogs for each teams, after that the life cycle is same for each team.
My question was about productivity, managing productivity, tracking productivity. Yeah. Individual product backlogs for estimates and nothing, then... One team's 500 story is not equivalent to other team's 500
story. For that, we need to baseline the story points. that we need to baseline the story. Baseline would be, for example, if you're working on a user story that talks about login functionality, and we say that login functionality has one user story point. So one story point. So one story point would be for that functionality. And now that is common for all these different teams. On the basis of that, they estimate that if they have this feature A, what comparing it to the login functionality, what would be the story points for this feature? Because now they have the same base. Again, we can continue introducing more baselines, maybe.
But I think, I'm not sure if I'm right or not, but I think we can have different baseline stories for different teams as well. I mean, it depends. I mean,
So let's keep these questions over. Once the framework will come, those frameworks should answer many things.
True.
So, anything else you want to present?
Yeah, so after that, we get into the inspect and adapt part of it. So, inspect, you will talk, and then I'll talk about the adapt part of it.
So here we are, inspect. Inspect means sprint review. So now this is means this will be become a more major challenge, because earlier it is related to a single team, now it is scaled. So means everyone knows what sprint review does. So now means here two questions came. One is sprint review. All sprint review can't be attended by client. Yes, it can be skipped, but means it should be done by PO. Means for that, product owner will be responsible to sign off that yes, now this sprint is covers all the requirement and now I can give sign off. So first one is product owner must be responsible for that sprint. Now another question is, who would do the integrated product demo? So ideally it would be means demo will be always given by a team, but in such scenario, who will be responsible? So yes, for that once amongst a product owner who has assigned the responsibility can give demo.
So your individual team demo, then one final demo.
Yes.
Right. So the final demo, what we are trying to say here is because there is some senior product owner or maybe whatever role you want to call it, he has the vision of it. So probably he knows that after every three sprint, he comes into a conclusion where, you know, I can show something to the business. It's like a shippable product probably, is when we would do that demo. But what we are trying to say is, and it's not only demo, it's way more than only a demo. So we are not getting into that detail. But just specifically talking about demo, so demo is important, it should be done. The only thing is the audience can change based on what level of product it is. Is it just increment? Is it just potential? Or is it actually shippable?
Yeah, good.
Just last.
Yeah, that's right.
For the retrospective. Adapt part. Retrospective, because there were multiple questions on retrospective. So, this could be sometimes a challenge that, when we, at a team level, it's easy to understand that what the team management say and get the feedback on the process and things like that. This has to be changed. This has to be changed. But, from a senior management perspective, you really need to give them a feedback that, or they need to know what exactly is needed from them. And sometimes it gets missed. Why? Because at the team level, and I'm talking a little bit practical aspect of it that, people might say, ki, yeah, okay, this is beyond me. So that's why I can't change that process. So there has to be a way. So we have tried something called as a Pareto analysis of retrospective. So what we normally do is, we have a to the team we say that okay, right, start, stop, continue is what we follow. That what things you should start, what you should stop, and what you should continue. But for start and stop, we also say that whatever action item you say, it should be among some of these categories related to team structure, related to collaboration, something similar categories we create, and every item retrospective. Item which comes has to be tagged to one of these things, and it has to have an assignee also. Now that assignee is not on a name, that assignee is three or four categories like management, maybe the dev team, or maybe the PO team, those kind of three or four buckets we create. So what that does is tomorrow from each team I collected that data, and then I can create a Pareto of saying that okay, majority of my action items lies on maybe management, or maybe on product teams, or And similarly, I can also create a Pareto on that where my focus should be. Is it my problem area is collaboration, or my problem area is team structure, the way we are operating. So that way, that retrospective helps me out to do that. And this fairly works when you have more than 6-7 teams of 8 or 9 size. Less than that, still you can manage actually, because that can be done manually. So that is one way of doing it.
Great. Any question? My idea is that we finish the thought process and then look at the framework, because framework is more thoughtful, so it will answer many things. So, team structure. Team
what?
Structure, collaboration, code integration.
Nothing, my question is still an answer. How do we divide the product backlog in team product backlog?
I think this will be covered in the same
framework.
There is a challenge.
So that's what I'm saying, because see, there will be many open questions which will come in your mind. The coming framework should answer it. There are something which is coming common, like they are also talking about framework, is also talking about, like that.
Good thing, without reading about framework,
yes.
They are coming up.
So like we are doing the last time what we did, test driven development. So this is again a test driven workshop. So first we identify the test, we have a failing test, and then we make it pass.
Okay, so the approach that we took, we picked up the pink stickies, we identified what all the challenges are, and we tried to address them and come up with, you know, our solutions based on our understanding as to how we can address each of those challenges. So the number one challenge was regarding the team structure. So the structure that we could think of, and this is again inspired by the Scrum of Scrums framework, that we are going to have multiple teams. So we imagine that, okay, let's say we have figured out that to complete this project, we are going to require an 80-member team working full-time. What do we do about it? How do we segregate into an appropriate structure which can work on Agile Manifesto, which can work on Agile principles? So what we did, we said that there are going to be multiple teams. Maximum number of team members in each team will be 9. There will be a business analyst or a product owner per team, and there will be one chief product owner. Now the responsibility of this chief product owner will be to ensure that we are following the product backlog, that the product roadmap is adhered to. So as my friends over there said that this is going to be a common product backlog, I think we agree over there. We also decided that there is going to be just one common product backlog. There is going to be one Scrum Master per team, and there is going to be one architect overall. So we are not going to have 8 architects or something of that sort, we are going to have just one architect, okay. And internally, this architect feels that I'm swamped with work, you know, I can't manage all on my own. He might have some junior architects reporting into him, but from our perspective, from our visibility point of view, there's going to be just one single architect. Each individual team will be co-located. So let's say we have got 8 teams out here, or 7 teams, or whatever that maths is. Each of their team will be co-located as much as possible, but the individual teams can sit on different floors, in different buildings, maybe at different locations. How do we solve the problem of coordination? There was one pink sticky which talked about coordination. So for coordination, there's going to be a practice known as daily scrum of Scrum Masters. Alright, so how do you do it in normal daily scrum within your team? Your 3 questions are, what did I do yesterday? What am I planning to do today? Are there any impediments or blockers? For this daily scrum of Scrum Masters, the questions will be, what my team did yesterday, what my team will be working on today, and if there are any impediments or blockers for my team, you know, where they are facing issues. So this might go for a little longer than 10 minutes per se, because here we are giving the status of the entire team rather than of an, just one member. But this is basically how we solve the problem of coordination. And another thing I think which we discussed about when Sanjay asked, in single team, and that's what Agile says, that, you know, rely on information radiators, rely on non-electronic modes of maintaining artifacts, maybe story cards, maybe index cards, maybe whiteboards, and you know, all that sort of stuff. But what I believe is, with a team structure of this size, you need to have electronic tools. You need to have tools like Pivotal Tracker, tools like Jira, you have this another tool called Velocity. And then you need to also have collaboration tools, maybe something like Basecamp, right? So you're not going to maintain your sprint backlog onto your whiteboards or something. You're going to track this thing electronically so that everyone can see how a team is progressing,
what the individual sprint looks like. It looks like healthy, it looks like meeting our expectation or not, and corrective measures can be taken. As far as the retrospective is concerned, I think you guys touched it already. We are of the opinion that retrospective can be, retrospective must be individual. So each team should conduct their own retrospective. We thought it should be extended one step further. Like we have daily scrum of scrum masters, we should have a retrospective of the scrum masters itself. So that in case there are common problems, in this case there are common issues, the wheel doesn't get reinvented for each team. Something of those lines. Review. This sprint review must be common for all teams because at the end, all these teams are building one product. So whatever increment happens to the product. It happens to the individual modules, but there is no fun if those individual increments are not adding up to the entire product. So the sprint review must happen for the entire product, and all team members should do that. They can nominate one person per team to give a demo and do stuff like that, but that should be one common retrospective. And I think that's pretty much it.
Just one point on coordination collaboration.
Yeah.
The synchronization was one important thing, where if you have multiple teams, their sprints will be synchronized, so they start at the same time, run for the same duration and in the same time.
Great. Yeah? Sure. Good. So we close this.
Just productivity tracking. What we thought was that's slightly different from you guys. We thought of having the story level estimation in the product backlog, because we don't have individual team backlogs. We have train sprint backlogs, but not individual product backlog. So the team level estimate will be done at the product backlog level. So that way the story points are same across all the teams. So that way it helps tracking productivity at the product level.
So that is kind of necessary for the burn down chart also, as the project level burn down chart is not.
Yes, exactly.
Because if you don't have an estimation at PB level, product backlog level, then you won't be able to create that burn down chart.
We have a challenge to that also, but yeah,
great.
Fair enough.
So, good.
Yeah, we missed out a couple of points.
Yeah.
The challenges regarding maintaining consistency in good coding practices and the integration part. I think we need to utilize tools as much as possible, and we need to introduce processes within the teams to ensure that the coding practices are being followed, the reviews are done in time within the sprint as soon as a user story is being completed. And again, for integration, whether one branch should be used or multiple branches should be used, there are various models available of branching, so any of those can be used. There is no one which is the best one to be utilized. So any model for branching that best suits the team and to all the multiple teams should be utilized. And the last challenge that was scaling productivity in linear fashion. Again, productivity within a scrum team or multiple scrum teams would not increase if we add a couple of more team members or if we add more teams in it. Again, it cannot be done in a linear way. This is just not possible. So it improves only by experience.
Okay, great.